said good day, sir!
Welcome back, everybody, here to our last game of the evening for the defense group stages, powered by Razor as well as BenQ. Power Rangers going up against the Copenhagen Wolves. Let's jump ourselves inside the game where the draft has already begun. I'm going to give some volume to my co-commentator, who is Ham Sandwich again, man. Welcome back for our last game of the night.
Yeah, nice to be here. Thank you for having me today.
Always a pleasure, man. Always a pleasure.
So this is basically a must-win situation for Wolves, this game. Lost to Helomoto, which puts them at 1-2, so they're looking to go at least 2-2. And then they're going to try and take a game off Quantic to go 3-2 in the series, or in the group stage, rather. That's going to be tough for them to do so, because Quantic has shown that they're a great team. They're currently 3-0 in the group, leading the group. Only CLG is close at 3-1. Yeah. And Power Rangers are also looking to get a couple wins and maybe salvage a fourth place finish in their group if they can win their next two games and finish the group 2-3. But that'll put them into most likely a tiebreaker situation. So it's going to be interesting to see how this group plays out. To start off with our bans for Power Rangers, we've got the Chaos Knight being banned out along with Leshrac and Enchantress. Whereas Wolves have chosen to ban out Lycanthrope and Prophet. Well, so a lot of the strong heroes getting taken out. But we still got some of those key heroes that that both teams like to play left in the mix.
Wondering if Darkseid is going to be able to get through the ban pool this
time
around.
That's what I'm wondering as well.
Wow. Wolves at this point, if they ban out the Chen or something along those lines right now, then Power Rangers have it open for them where they can go for the Darkseer. But Wolves can also answer back as well, like Enigma's still in the pool for this, so they can grab themselves up their own form of team fight.
Yeah, they can still take up the Invoker if they want it.
Mm-hmm.
Got all these powerful heroes still in the pool, and I think part of it is just deciding exactly what you want to do. If you're going to go for a push strat, you want to ban all the anti-pushers and that's sort of what we see Wolves doing here. They're banning out the Broodmother, so they don't really want to play against too much push. And Power Rangers have picked up the Chen.
Mm-hmm. So Brood to be removed, Chen picked up, and that means Darkseer gets to go to the Copenhagen Wolves if they want it. That's if they want it.
They can pick up both the Invoker and the Darkseer here if they choose to. But we may go back to those, and they pick up the Darkseer, and they go Enigma as well.
One of the easiest laners in the world to throw a Darkseer in, especially if he's allowed to be aggressive. That might be a big problem right now for Wolves. They might think of it this way, where if they throw Darkseer down there on that bot lane to try and sell it up for them, having that Chen allows that buffer, because a lot of Darkseers like sit between the tier 1 and the tier 2 tower and just soak up the damage there. And it lets it do a lot of damage to the T1 tower and bot lane of the Radiant side. But the downside of this is, Chen grabs one creep. If it's a Centaur or a Troll, then Darkseer is going to find himself getting killed very, very early on in the game. And now Invoker, because the Enigma was picked up by Wolves, gets to be picked up by Power Rangers, and they go up with the Brewmaster as well. So if Wolves want to have the huge-ass team fight potential, they're going to try and go with the hero that's able to survive it all, or at least hope to survive it, so then he can pop off the Primal Split.
Yeah, and we've even got the Chen to help him do that. Hand of God, if your Brewmaster's getting a little low and can't get off his ulti, Hand of God, give him that extra couple seconds so he can pop it off, and you can really control the team fight that way. Power Rangers look like they may not have nearly as much team fight as Wolves at this point, just because they don't really have a big, huge disable in the form of Enigma Black Hole, or even something along the lines of Tidehunter or Sand King. But they do have that Hand of God, which shouldn't be underestimated as a teamfight skill. Even though it's a heal, it still is a great teamfight skill.
Mm-hmm. So let's see, what does Wolf want as their last one? Or just lost, Fennec just re-came back into the game. Wolf's taking the sweet-ass time on this one, and they go the Venomancer. So I think at this point the toss-up is, do we try and go all push? Do we try and go for the all out push, or do we just say, you know what, it's not really going to work for us if we try that. Let's try something a little bit more stable. So we go counter push as such. That's what the Venomancer can give you. Gives them even more teamfight control out from Venomancer on top of what they've already got. So yeah, there's a lot for Wolves to play with just their lineup right now. But they still miss out the damage dealers. They miss out the solo and good laners. And that's why you see instantly Power Rangers banning out that Queen of Pain, knowing just what a combo that would be for Wolves.
Yeah, Wolves here have shown a push strategy. They've laid out a push strategy in the cards as their first three heroes. So Power Rangers have got to be aware that that's a possibility. But Wolves also have the option of saying, oh, we're going to keep only these three pushers and we're going to take two very good lane controllers or two farmers instead. Mm-hmm. So that sort of leaves them that option open. And because they have last pick, they sort of get to decide exactly what they want to do after Power Rangers have already finished their entire strategy. Mm-hmm. And part of that, I think, here is Power Rangers showing a non-committal pick with the Crystal Maiden. Crystal Maiden can support the Brewmaster, can support another hero. It doesn't really matter. They have so many options for their last pick. They want to make Wolves reveal a little bit more of their strategy before Power Rangers decide what they're going to finish out their lineup with.
Well, Wolves now going to grab up the Beastmaster. So even more great initiation from them. They're going to use the Beastmaster for that one. That also gives them the options for their bottom lane. But kind of leads me a little bit more towards that middle lane. Ties the last one out from Power Rangers. So they're assuming a melee right-click kind of hero, but Wolves can change it up. In fact, they could almost look, and I would literally like to see them pick it up right now as a Klynx, as their final selection of a hero. Less Enigma, if he needs to salt the middle lane, Darkseer into the jungle, Beastmaster for the pull and bot, and Venomancer and Klynx on the top lane would hurt like hell, but they say, screw you, and go Storm Spirit Aggression. So Calculus gets his aggressive kind of hero, and it's a positional aggressive kind of hero as Storm Spirit.
Yeah, Storm Spirit's great at zipping in, zipping out, controlling the outskirts of the main team fight, as well as providing that damage when Enigma gets his black hole off, when Beastmaster roars. Just a good complement hero to what Wolves already have on the table.
Mm-hmm. So let's roll ourselves out. Well, we go from Power Rangers. Phanus will be onto that Tidehunter. It'll be followed by ZXC, taking up the role as the Invoker. ASDL playing at the role as the Brewmaster. Crystal Maiden playing by Darillion. And that leaves our last one, which is Rain TT, taking up the role as Chen. Over on towards Wolves' side, what do we got? Up on the top lane, Henry Dickinson. So we got ourselves a support, and there goes Wolves. Losing off a lot of the heroes. And then a quick reconnection back in again. So it looks like they must have just bugged out with either the mini-map or... just graphics, okay. But Henry Dickinson going to take that Enigma, so it's going to be a big jungle Enigma for him. Calculus is the Storm Spirit, Nino onto the Venomancer. Balsam will be the Beastmaster, so he will be going down towards that middle lane, actually, by the looks of it. And leaves Darkseer, and they are going to let him solo that bot lane. Even though I was talking about the perils of what happens when you got yourself a Chen, he still feels that he can do it, so he's going to solo that bot lane, which means Balsam in towards the middle lane, Venomancer to support him later on. Or Beastmaster top with the Venom support, also an option as well.
They may be expecting Power Rangers to run an aggressive top tri lane, which leaves Darkseer in a 1v1 matchup, which is a lot easier for him. And it allows them to again skirt around the forest and plant himself between the two towers. But that relies upon Chen doing an aggressive jungle, which is sometimes scary for Chen's. Especially if Wolves is going to have their tri-lane on top. But for now, it looks like Power Rangers are just going to be hunting out and see if they can catch one Wolves, like perhaps a Venomancer, a little bit out of position here.
Well, that's going to be difficult, though. Like, the only way they can do it is with Fog of War, and that Gush needs to be able to hear from Tidehunter, and he's got the vision and range for it.
Oh, he's got it.
So the Gush's going to go. There's a lot of them there, and then he gets four in the Gale. Dickinson was just sitting there watching by, but now they know, okay, all five heroes up on the top lane, and they had to take their sweet-ass time to get themselves into the lanes, because that slow from the Gale has only just ended now. And a regen room, Brewmaster can take that, he's the lowest. They're gonna walk past, he's like, yeah, guys, regen, did you see the regen?
Tide should take it because he used mana. But Tide is actually going to be soloing this top lane, which we see out of CLG every once in a while, but they usually like to run it on the bottom lane.
Mm-hmm. We got to see our melee range combo here in the mid. Crystal Maine as well as Brewmaster. It'll be Balsam as well as the Venomancer, who actually Nino's designed to not really stick here in the lane. It means Balsam gets a lot of harassment early on. Novas as well as Keg is being dropped. And it means he must be coming in to help out with this. It's like, oh, okay, well, I see a regen rune. That's not going to help me. Again, what's that, fourth time today now? I think fourth time today now. The first rune has been regen. Nobody ever wants to see one of those guys. Give me a double damage. Give me an invis. It's actually Beastmaster spamming of his abilities. Crystal Maiden wants to get in range for a denial. But not going to happen. And Beastmaster will take it.
It's actually really helpful for a Beastmaster to start. Just because he has such a low mana pool. Two sets of axes, and he's out of mana.
And those axes actually helped him along, too. He's getting 500 gold, 50 gold away from a bottle. Now 4 gold, 3 gold, 2 gold, 1 gold. Bottle up 1 minute 30 in. Key item for Balsam.
Right now we just have Chen farming, actually. So Chen's already level 2. He's got, he's got only one creep. He needs to wait until he's level 5 to get another one.
Mm-hmm. I'm getting a weird bloody thing with my mouse inside the game where I'm getting a graphical glitch with it. Just for those guys who are inside the game, I'm just going to turn that off very, very quickly.
I'll update everybody as to what's happening. We've got Beastmaster using his bottle effectively already, picking up that invis rune. But we do have a lot more control out of this mid lane by Power Rangers, given the fact that they have two heroes here. Mm-hmm. Tidehunter running away from this Venomancer actually does get hit by the Kale.
Yeah, but Nino can't chase it. It's just keeping Tide off the lane. That's all it really wants.
Calculus a lot of space to farm here. Especially because they've got the Enigma who can come out from the jungle at any point.
That's true. Henry Dickinson kind of being ignored in there. He's already sitting at 17 for nil CS. Leveling up with a Brewmaster. He's going that mid-roll. That farming mid-roll too. And this was waiting for S4 to happen. This could be our first blood as well. Does the entire creep wave. And in comes Chen. Clap will be there. Slows him down. He does have the surge. But that cold snap still causing issues. And he gets it up in the
nice
air.
Oh, nice tornado.
Yep, first blood. This is the problem of running Darkseer on the bottom lane. First blood.
As soon as you have that second hero go in, you're running into trouble as Darkseer. All it takes is one hero to rotate, and your little area behind these two towers is suddenly not so safe.
Mm-hmm. Love how Invoker really believes his phase boots are going to be worth this. Running through a creep wave, taking 150 damage instead of waiting for the new one to arrive. He does get his phase boots up 3 minutes in. Must be getting some good space down there. Now he's 13 for 7. I'm just going to force Darkseer out. Even though there's the Iron Shell out there, it's on one of the Dire Creeps, which he can keep his space out from. It's one of the Dire Creeps, which was dying pretty fast as well.
I think the biggest problem right now is this Tidehunter. He's really not getting anything. He's 0 for 0.
Henry Dickinson decides to turn and say, okay, Crystal Maiden, I'll show you how to play a Crystal Maiden. But he's Enigma, so we can't really show him how to play it. Unless he watched last game. S4's in trouble again. Being chased down by Chen as well as the Ursa. Might see if they can cut him off for the pass, but that Ursa's not going to get there in time. Surge being used by S4 gets him back to safety. Radiant's bottom tower. But it is forcing Invoker. Well, it's not even forcing him. This is bringing Invoker off that bottom lane a lot. He keeps rotating out and leaving his farm behind.
He's trading a lot of his farm to try and harass this Darkseer down.
Radiant's bottom tower. But then you got to watch Stormspear on top lane and see the difference between these two guys. Invoker on that bottom lane. Had to pick up 16 for 8. Darkseer is causing him those issues, but Calculus up on that top lane hits 30 CS. He's the same as the Brewmaster in the middle lane. But then again, watching middle lane, we've got Beastmaster who's got 14 for nil. So everything starts to balance. They give me a CM stun just on the edge of the range for it.
And then Beastmaster. She lifted up her staff.
But it didn't cast, man. It didn't cast. You got to swoosh and flick on that.
I think the biggest problem right now is this Tidehunter. If we look at Darkseer, he has died once, but he's at 20 for 1 for creeps. Tidehunter's at 1 for 0. And it's only just barely level 3. So he's going to need to find the farm somewhere. He's sort of just wandering around trying to control the river area because he just can't stand up to this dual lane. Storm Spirit's already level 6. We'll be able to kill Tide easily with the help of Venomancer.
And S4 is in a lot of trouble. He's trying to surge himself out. And a wonderful combination else again here by the Invoker. ZXC does all the damage he possibly can with a Coil Snap, then invokes himself into that tornado. And he's done it perfectly twice and got a kill on the Darkseer for it twice.
Yeah, Darkseer is being a little bit more aggressive than this Tide. And that's partly why he's got more CS, but also partly why he's got 2 deaths to his name.
Mm-hmm. He starts throwing experience the other way as well as gold. Now experience onto the Invoker. Invoker now going to pop level 7 on that bottom lane. He's looking great. I suppose the rest of his team, you're right, they are very, very low on levels. But Invoker's about managed to get 418 experience per minute and also 337 in the gold per minute. He's feeling good, man. He's feeling really, really good. And it is actually the trade-off, too. Like, you're talking about Tidehunter being low. Look at the Venomancer. He's level 2. He's got absolutely nothing up in this top lane until he can start pulling and farming. And he's going to double pull this stack right now. But it's all for the greater farm, so they can give it to Henry Dickinson. They want to work it up so they can have him with that mech as early as possible.
Yeah, Venomancer might want to steal some of this experience from Henry Dickinson, just so that he can have a few more levels, especially because once he gets that
bottom lane kill.
Yeah.
That was actually Darkseer and Beastmaster combining. Must have used that Invis rune finally, the Beastmaster, but S4 too far out. Third kill now for the Invoker. And all three have gone to him as well, it hasn't been split. So Darkseer throws away what he just worked hard to get, which was the kill on Chen. And that was Beastmaster gone for a while as well.
Beastmaster Roar was used. And we got Beastmaster leveling up at the same rate as Brewmaster, pretty much, in the mid lane, even though there's this Crystal Maiden support. So it just shows you how much control can come out. And we've actually got a
trouble.
Split here by Panda.
Yeah, but he can do this solo. The Fire Panda Crystal Maiden's going to help out and just beat down the Beastmaster. And this is the power of the Power Rangers draft. Once that level 6 appears for the Brewmaster, he's just able to do anything he wants to. But the counter push comes on top lane. Siege creep here with a couple of conversions. And there'll probably be a tier 1, actually not even a tier 1 tower trade. Top lane push from Wolves is going to be successful where Power Rangers, they get a kill. But it ends there.
And Calculus, you see, is rushing that silent stick for the Broodmaster, or for the Broodmaster.
Brewmaster.
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 That's the one.
Brewmaster. Brewmaster.
For the Panda, I'm just going to call it that.
Beastmaster's in trouble. It's going to let off the Roar as a last-ditch effort here on the Tidehunter. Just to deal some kind of damage. Holds the Axis for now. And S4 again's on the run from the Centaurs of Chen. The Tornado won't hit either, but it's a continuous push on the top lane. They've got Chen and Invoker hunting Darkseer. He's about to TP himself out, and the stuns aren't there. And Ty came down for that as well, while Henry Dickinson, Nino, as well as Calculus, continue their push on the top lane. They haven't finished it off just yet. They need that new creep wave to come in.
But nobody on Power Rangers even has a TP yet. Like, none of their heroes right now have a TP, so they can't do anything to stop this. They're going to have to walk. And that's just going to give all the time that Wolves need to take this tower and to get out successfully.
Mm-hmm. And because of all of this, in fact, we've got level 6 up on the Enigma, and he's only 100 gold away from his Blink Dagger. We're not even 10 minutes in, and the Storm's going to jump. They're going to catch out the Tidehunter. He's level 3, so why not? Hand of God won't keep him up for long. Centaurs will make a move. But it was Venomancer getting the kill. Supports came through, and that's now 100 gold for the Enigma.
Darkseer is back to being between these towers, but he knows he's a little bit safer now.
Courier. She don't be here. But then again, holy crap!
Oh man, that's a lot of cold snap.
Just using the Wex, he's just able to just make the most of the cold snap. Salve's gonna keep S4 alive for the moment. He's got no stick charges and one surge, but one right click will do the job. Is that the fifth kill now? Fourth kill for him.
All of them on Darkseer.
Uh-huh. And Crystal Maiden. Managing to get one nice little stun there on Kalk, but the roll flies through. Axe as well. Kalk will jump away. And Bolson will finish off the CM. But Brewmaster coming in. He needs the Kegger. Right click. He doesn't need the Kegger. He just needs Invoker with Phase Boost to keep up and get that right click in.
Yeah, Invoker's already at Phase Boost Drum, which makes him so fast this early into the game.
You can't outrun that, man. Like, what is his movement speed? This is a standard. We've got 280 plus 76. Has he got anything on him? No, that's just himself. That is the movement speed.
Yeah, and he goes all the way up to...
plus 182, just destroying the Venomancer.
When he's phased, he's at 182.
Now 192.
Yeah, he keeps putting more into Wex, so it gets faster and faster.
You want to try and outrun that and the smoke? Movement speed is there for him. Up to 200. What are you? Just pop 270 at one point? Plus? Wait for those phase boots to go again. I kind of want to see that. Come on, man. Pop your phase boots. Make a run. Run, Forest. Run. Nah, let's say screw it. Let's just push bottom lane. Brewmaster now with a blink dagger as well. Picking it up from the side shop. Tornado will fly through. Wonderful EMP. It's going to stop Henry Dickinson from getting that black on, but he'll turn around. We'll still pop it nonetheless. And the four star pushing the Invoker in. So three get caught in the end. Venomancer Alderman not there. He's still low. And Brewmaster pops off his. Enigma and Storm go down. S4 is out. Nino wants out. Ty taking a lot of damage. It's Balsam down here. A long way past the T1 tower. And now he's trapped up. Earth Panda can follow up with the stun. Tornado trying to slow them down. Venomancer set up in the air. There's the Earth Panda stun. Tornado will die from the fall. And Invoker, also, he's just burning a little bit from that tower. Switching himself into Quas so he can survive it. And Chen will send him back to base. In the meantime, S4 is looking for Brewmaster. He flicks himself away. Drops the Kegger. That is Nino slowing him down. The tower damage is doing his job as well. Tower hit, it's not going to be enough. Able to live through it. And Nino trying to look for an extra Gale on anything.
Oh, and there go all the Chen army. He's going to be sad about that.
Oh, but they're going to get Darkseer. Oh, man, what a time. Man. They didn't get the right chain off, though. That Surge is still going to have a little bit of time to go. But they did the CM stun there to troll. Tide, really? Oh, this is going to be troublesome. 3 euros going to TP, and EMP's already gone. Nino just burns from that. Ravage will pop, but Dickinson not caught in it. The double kill now for the Invoker. CM with a stun. Troll can follow up with a trap, only just coming off cooldown. Storm is here, and Invoker is right-clicking him down, but Storm trying to bring down the Crystal Maiden. Jumping a little bit closer, Tide will take a fall, and Invoker jumps himself inside Invis. He's out of range of the towers, and TP's on cooldown for another 26 seconds. They must be expecting him to go west. But he's still out. Is that Dust TPing in?
Here comes the courier with Dust.
Venomancer comes in with Dust. He'll pop it. And Invoker spins and tries to run. But Roar is going to be used for this one just to ensure that kill. And that's a big kill for the Beastmaster. 610. The godlike streak is now ended.
That's the power of an Invoker with a great start, though. 9 kills? He's just doing so much damage so early. Taking the time to go off and kill that Darkseer, but it's well worth it if you look at the fact that he's level 12. Storm, who's in the similar positions, only at level 10, even though Storm has more creeps.
But the difference is actually not that much when you look at the global thing. It's 1,500 going the way of Power Rangers. They did have an advantage of, it almost looked like 4K. Almost. As far as gold goes, it hasn't really left Wolf's side. They went on a 4K advantage as far as gold went because the towers they took on top. And now the kills they take and that extra bonus gold after killing off the Invoker. He gave a lot to Wolves during that last engagement.
Yeah, he gave a lot of gold and a lot of experience. I mean, the fact that Beastmaster is able to pick up an early medallion as well as a bracer. Just those two little early items that'll help him do so much more just from a simple kill. Mm-hmm.
It's amazing what one kill can do for you. Try and turn a game around. How's the CS actually looking? The Storm Spirit's got a crap ton of CS. 87 for 26. He's looking good, man. He's looking really good. His gold per minute is now higher than the Invoker. For a man who's getting so many kills, that's no small achievement. And Darkseer goes back into farming. Looks like he's trying to build towards what could be a Vanguard, but he'll be probably looking for a pipe if possible. I don't know if anyone else is building towards that. We go from Beastmaster, Medallion, Tranquils. I think we're already as the mech. Venomancer, there's no way he's going to be able to afford a pipe. And now the push coming from Power Rangers again. They're all grouping up for the bottom lane. And they'll take this tier 1 tower pretty fast. Invoker just right clicking it from range. Double TP coming to the tier 2. Axe to fly as well. Looks like they want to try and defend this a little bit. Tower being denied out by the Beastmaster. EMP just burns down S4. And the Thieber going a little bit further. Gush goes out and bolts them. That roar
is. Look at how fast Invoker is.
That roar is off cooldown. So if they do want to go for this, they've got to be careful how far they want to extend. And in the meantime, Calc, as well as Brewmaster, the two who basically cannot kill each other, are going up against each other. You get the Brewmaster split, which will now be used, but Calc will just ulti himself away. Doesn't have a large chunk of mana, so they might be able to get this kill. There's the jump. Oh, no!
Take it.
He had to do the second jump up. He almost failed it, and Henry Dickinson pops the smoke. Oh, the ultimate troll. And he jumps back into the ultimate form. I think Dickinson was really thinking about popping off the black hole just then.
Yeah, or at least a Malifus, and then and then have follow-up from the Storm Spirit.
Mm-hmm. Beastmaster able to swipe off the double damage. Not having that Soul Ring means he's not going to stack off those Ancients. He's doing it for the team. He still thinks he can kill them off, which he can do so, but he's going to run out of mana pretty fast. That's where the double damage comes in.
I double damage and Medallion, just let him take that so fast.
Hawk getting scouted out there by Henry. He had the vision of the Hawk moving, so just knew where it was going to try and go in, Viz. And the Nova still has its effect. Big item now for Storm Spirit to be completed is that Orchid. He has the cash for it. And again, Invoker's getting close as well, but Calc just jumping out. Oh man, did that cost that really hit? He jumps up inside the trees, but he can't get out of here. He binds up the recipe, but he has no mana. He tries to jump, but it's not through the trees far enough.
Did Power Rangers know he's there, though?
No, not at all. They can't see him. There's no vision inside those trees for him. Oh, now they see him. Having some right-click fun. And Calc caught in the worst position possible.
It was that tornado that scouted it for them. That crafty Wildkin.
Tornado, most powerful ability in the game. Middle lane being defended right now by Power Ranger, but bottom lane's being pushed out by Beastmaster. So only got one point in that inner beast, but they're going to have that top tier 1 tower take a fall. I'm surprised they're going to stop right now. They're going to TP out. Yeah, they're going to defend their tier 2s. So tier 2 tower on bottom lane, Invoker TPs for that. And he's also got the money now for his Orchid and buys it.
So Storm and Invoker are going very similar item builds, which makes it very easy to compare the amount of farm that each of them have. Mm-hmm. Got some defense here. TP actually gets cancelled by the Tidehunter onto bottom tower.
Maybe thought it wasn't worth it in the end. Crystal Maiden was rotating, but the Dire of a Ward watching for this. And now the Hawk as well. Roar to go out, and they're going to go Invoker with a Medallion of Courage. Hand of Gold will keep him alive for a little bit back as well. But Invoker, how do we get out to safety? And Crystal Maiden, going to get the stun. Same time, Darkseer, try to throw anything else off. Is the damage going to be there? He has to run. But cannot run fast enough. And Balsam will also TP out before Tide's going to find him. And that's what happens when you try and pressure an Invoker when you got a Chen on the field. That was only a level 1 Hand of God as well. And looks like Chen's finished up his mech. I guess that's what's flying out to him right now on the courier. Yes it is. Hello, middle lane.
Calculus.
Yep, trying to go on the Brewmaster, but there's, one big charge.
Yeah, now that he's got his Orchid, he can afford to be a little bit more liberal with his mana usage. But he's still got to be careful. He doesn't want to be caught out with no mana in the middle of the woods like he was.
Uh-huh. times I had that, when you basically got to facepalm yourself as the Storm Spirit to get your mana pool up, and you can do so much. The mana pool only at 1.1k, that's not a lot. Banner's trying to get towards the front line, just to try and help kill off this creep wave. And that Tornado's doing all the job it needs to, and jump up there by Brewmaster. Stomp is there, EMP trying to vac him in, but already Cal gets gone. That is the shortest black hole of his life. And that's going to be Beastmaster going down inside the jungle. Ravage will pop. S4 also caught out by that one. Gush a fly out too. But Nino finally falls down from the skies, gets his ultimate off. But it's Invoker who's on the run. The Cold Wall is up. But the retreat from Wolves. Tier 2 tower will be the follow-up here by Power Rangers. Mech Charge will pop again.
Chen's got three Wildkins. That's just so many Tornadoes.
Are they all on cooldown too?
Yes.
Yeah, they are. Every single one started at the same time. And they might just push. Wolfgans can tank this up. They might start another set of Tornadoes by the time Wolves comes up, but how much damage can they deal with this tower? They get rid of the creep wave fast enough. And Dickinson kind of wants to have a little bit of fun right now. Fannis, Hand of Gold will go off here from Rain TT. And, S4 was thinking about it.
Yeah, but he's chosen not to take Wall of Replica. Often you see Darkseers take Wall at level 10 and then again at level 11. But we see here S4 saving Wall for 13, 14, and 16. Mm-hmm. It's just such a good turtle ability. I don't always understand why people skip it in favor of an extra surge level. But at the same time, he's needed to get away from a couple of situations, so I can understand wanting to go at a fast
Storm
rate.
Jumping on Crystal Maiden there in the middle lane, jumping a little bit further up, and Chen, Mech Heal, and Nukage just disintegrates the Storm Spirit, and Crystal Maiden gets sent back to base.
Yeah, and Wolves can't do Roshan anymore.
They have to abandon it. Look at the triple tornado. A triple tornado flying into the Rosh Pit. And he cancels them off and says, you know what, let's just stop this. This is madness. This is absolute madness.
That's almost unfair how silly that number of tornadoes is. So if you think about it, tornado does... I don't even remember what tornado does. Like, does 40 close damage and 20 far away damage, and you've got three of them stacked on it. It's like having a radiance.
And does the slow actually stack as well?
I assume it does. I'm not 100% sure.
Should be no reason why I shouldn't. Oh, look. Crystal Mage just throwing out the Nova. The second the Balsam wanted Vision up with that Hawk, he sensed it coming. Now he drops the ward himself. Beastmaster starts the Medallion, throws out the Axe, but the EMP Tornado perfectly positioned there on Wolves. And Storm wants to jump. Ravage will pop. All five heroes caught in that one too. Cackle's going to die again before the fight even begins. They're able to hold their lives. Hand of God's up in 1 second. Nino will pop off the Oldman, but who cares? The life is up here for Power Rangers. They get the stun here on Henry Dickinson. Still no ulti from him. Chen drops down the nuke. Hand of God will finally pop. And now look for the Nino. Trying to get out. He is gushed, he is anchored, and he is dead. Three heroes gone from Wolves, and this will be their Tier 2 tower and bot lane following very, very shortly after.
We've got great push out here from PR, and I wouldn't be surprised if they... Well, they have two options here. They can go to the base, or they can go to Roshan, and I wouldn't be surprised to see them pick up Roshan right after this.
Roshan will be easy enough, man. They still got those Wilkins to tank up. Not that I think Chen wants to lose those guys. It's not as if they're going to run out of mana while there's so many while he's running around with Arcane Boots. And they go in for Roshan.
And they can take it so fast with that Gush. Minus 5 armor on Roshan. Mm-hmm.
What is Roshan really going to do against that? He goes down. I don't know if you also noticed, Chen's only 1500 away from having his Aghanim set 24 minutes in. So continuous heals, just keep that push going every 30 seconds. You get 300? 300 life at the moment now on the second. Damn, I'm good. 400 on the ulti though. Kalk trying to get out of here. He's got a TP, but Invoker's found him. EMP will go. Burns away 2/3 of his mana. Now, the rest of his life is also removed by the Kega, the Gush, and the right clicks from Invoker with the Orchid hit on him as well. Could not do anything.
Yeah, Storm went from an okay start to a pretty poor mid-game, and that's only because of Invoker's Orchid.
Mm-hmm.
Storm just can't do anything. Removes the entire mobility of Storm Spirit that that Orchid does and makes him a sitting duck in every team fight.
The tornado start again. Up towards the front lines. There's the Kega dropping. Nice Darkseer wall. It's going to force Power Rangers to go through there, but they've already killed off the Darkseer. Now they're going to focus on the Beastmaster after Broodlings are already been popped out. And, yep, they will be able to fight. Invoker walks through the wall, but the Broodlings don't even have any effect when they do so. Double buyback now coming out from Wolves. They want to try and hold this tower, but they cannot fight in the middle. Now tight under. Ravage going to pop off. Hand of God as well as the mech. Pop that Ravage to cancel off Henry Dickinson. He can't. He's currently silenced. He can't do anything. Now he pops at the black hole. Really nicely catching out Power Rangers, but Crystal Maiden now dropping the element. Nice back out as well. Double kill for the Crystal Maiden. Cal going to get right click down. Orchid last throw out there. Buyback by the Storm Spirit. Anything that will save this Rax he wants to do. But Invoker is still sending a full life, full mana. And now going to go on Calc, able to bring him down. Deafening Blast pushes him back. Brewmaster with a stop. The damage is still done. He's going to pop from the Orchid nonetheless. But Brewmaster finishes it with a crit, a blink to a crit. And bottom Rax will go down.
And PR can rotate if they want to, or they can pop out and just farm a little bit more and come back even stronger.
Well, that's what they're going to do, man. No need to overextend. No need to overextend at all.
Just playing that safe push when you have an advantage, fall back when it's even, and just try and build up as big of a lead as you can. Mm-hmm. And it's this Tidehunter, I think, that's been doing it for them. I mean, Invoker obviously has been doing a ton. He's already got 15 kills, only one death. And has been doing so well with his Orchid on the Storm Spirit.
Uh-huh.
We even got a Blink Dagger on the Crystal Maiden.
We now got a second Initiator. Screw the Agonim Scepter on Brewmaster, who wants to go on S4 right now. He's just used his Surge as well. And look at the phase boost keeping up. He's got Yasha, so the damage which comes out from Brewmaster is so ridiculously stupid.
Yeah, Brewmaster hasn't even died yet. And, I'm actually wondering what he's going to do, whether he's going to go for push with the Yasha into Mantis Bell, or whether he's
being jumped on. EMP's already going to hit, and he is disintegrated.
That is the Orchid at work.
Mm-hmm. Add the Orchid on top of a 300 crit, which Brewmaster is currently doing, and the damage Invoker does with his right clicks, which is 150 to 160. Well, we've got no, it's 100. It's actually 200 per hit. But that's the standard numbers, of course.
Yeah, and Storm Spirit's not a very healthy hero, and he didn't go Bloodstone, so he doesn't have any extra HP that way. He doesn't have a lot of strength gain. So he's just running really around on power trades. We got a split from the Panda.
Is he actually jumping in? He's jumping in on Balsam. The rest of the team is taking care of the Rax, while Tide is in a good position. He doesn't want to do the Ravage. Enigma's going to come back down to Earth. Blinks up. Deafening Blast won't hit. He gets silence on the way back down again. So that Orchid on top of him and the Sun. But he's back in the back in range of his well. But the middle lane, the Rax is gone. There goes the wall as well. So that was kind of like the last. Well, that wasn't even the last hope. EMP forcing Wolves out the side. Now Beastmaster only got enough for a roar and then he's out. Venomance will get a decent ultimate off, but Titan is still in position for a Ravage. Three heroes there, black hole, nicely done by Dickinson. So Storm can jump, trying to pull the Invoker out, but the Ravage and Anchor Smash from Tidehunter. Crystal Maiden as well with her ultimate. Double kill for her. Let her get the Beastmaster as well. Right click goes up. It is! It's a triple kill for the Crystal Maiden. And the Midrax as well. And Power Rangers take their first game here in the defense. And force the Copenhagen Wolves now to be 1-3 in their group stage. Leveling it up. Hello Moto is also 1-3 as well. So we actually have ourselves a three-way tie on the fourth position.
It's going to come down to these last few games, and every team is in a must-win situation. They're going to be fighting for these, as Calculus goes down again to this Orchid. They're going to be fighting for these last two positions into the playoff spots.
Mm-hmm. Run, Dickinson. Run. You got this, man. You got this. No, you don't have this. Godlike is up. At least they have fun, these guys. Have fun. Come here! Get over here! It's gonna be the full hit. Hand of God, mech charge, everything they want. The throne's been brought down. And Balsam hides inside. That's gonna be the it for today as well, guys. Thanks for tuning in. This is your defense coverage. We come back again tomorrow. At this point, I believe Fnatic versus NextKZ is the only confirmed game. And that'll be happening at 18 CEST tomorrow. Keep your eyes on joinedota.com as well as the-defense.com. It is a place where you can find out all the details for everything that is Dota 2 as well as the defense. Check out the grids, check out everything else. And also just check out the countdown. Nice easy way to find it. Top left hand corner of both the websites. It will appear there. But that is GG. That is going to be the end. And Ham, we're going to wrap up tonight, man. It's been fun.
Yes, it is. Some good games tonight. And we're almost done the group stage. We're almost into playoffs.
Yeah, group stage actually ends this Sunday. It should probably end on Monday as the last game being MTW going up against NAVI. That should be our final match for the group stages. So if you want to keep up to date with everything or miss anything from today, joinedota.com, your place to go to. Until then, thanks for watching, guys. I will see you all tomorrow. Rest well, sleep well, play Dota more. Catch you guys soon.
I said good day, sir!